Hello and welcome to my gaming table. Here we are with ASL Starter Kit number 1, Scenario 1, all set up and ready to play. The difference, of course, is that we are using this set of rules. We are playing Retro, the tactical World War II wargame variant rules, which is an attempt on behalf of Gary Graber and Minden Games to make kind of an abbreviated, more easily playable version of a tactical World War II game using mainly squad leader components, advanced squad leader. They say you could use it with any system, and the nice thing is if you want any chrome from the old system, it's very easy to incorporate it into the new. This is turn one. I'm just going to start playing it. And as we go, I will explain the finer points of the differences between what I know of the ASL starter kit and combat commander and squad leader and some of the tactical stuff I've played with what we're seeing in Retro, mostly comparison with squad leader. Before I start, I just want to point out one other thing. When you pick up a copy of Retro, it comes with this card. This is just basically a card of some chits that you can make by cutting it out and mounting it, or just cutting it out as it is. I have not done that yet. I tend to mess things up when I do things with my hands, which is why I'm a writer, not a plumber. So what I plan on doing is just scanning this and printing it to photo quality paper, and then I'm going to try Derek Case's suggestion of mounting these to a piece of floor tile, which would be about the perfect thickness and everything. I'm really excited about giving that a try, but it comes with this. Now, the only thing we really need to worry about in this on this sheet right now is the halt counters, which is a part of the movement phase, and I alluded in the previous video that they have a thing called hesitation, and if that occurs, use one of these markers. But instead, what I'm going to do, I've got this wonderful little box that I had gotten of little centimeter cubes, so I'm going to use a yellow centimeter cube to indicate where hesitation has taken place. Let's take a look at how it goes. According to this, the Germans are to go first. So we're going to begin turn one with the rally phase. Rally phase is pretty much the same thing as it is in ASL. Both sides rally. Of course, at this point, neither side has anybody they need to rally. Now let's move on to the German movement phase. There is no prep fire or anything like that. The sequence of play is very simple. It's rally phase, movement phase, fire phase, defensive fire, and then close combat. And then you just, you know, lather, rinse, repeat. So what I'm going to do is start with this unit right here, and I'm going to move him 1, 2, 3. That's one of the things that's the same, pretty universal, is the movement factors between Retro and ASL. And now I have this stack here. It's a 7-0 and 2-4-4-7 squads, and they have a movement capacity of 6. And what I'm going to do is move them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into that building right there. This group of 4-4-7s, as I alluded in the introduction, I want them to end up here, so I'm going to have them go 1, 2, 3, 4. And in this stack we have an 8-1 liter and 2 4-4-7s, and I'm going to try and scurry them down here, so they're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and occupy that building just a stone throw away from, as mentioned last time, the 4 objective hexes, which are conveniently dry right marked for your convenience, but mostly for my faulty memory. Having completed movement, there is a fire phase. However, everyone who is eligible to fire has moved, so there will be no German fire this time. Now we have defensive fire. in retro, any unit that is within 3 hexes of an enemy unit may fire at them. And providing you've got line of sight and everything. So this guy is eligible to receive fire, but the line of sight there is blocked. I am just like 99 and 44 100% sure that that building cuts that off like that. So we're not going to worry about that. No fire eligibility from here. He is out of range. The only person capable of firing is these guys right there. 1, 2, 3. So these guys in the street, the 747s, are going to take a shot. Here is a brief look at the retro fire or infantry fire table, which is what I'm going to be using. Retro also comes with a couple of player aid cards with this information on them, so I'm not going to keep the rule book open at all times. Basically, this works a lot like squad leader and ASL, in that you take the highest number of firepower factors. So this 747 will be rolling on the 6 table, and we get a result of a 7. And on that combat table, under a 7 is no effect. And then we'd add another 3 to it because they are sitting in a stone building, so that's a 10. So it's even more of a clean miss, and we move along. That's the only fire opportunity. So now we move into the close combat phase. And this is one of the interesting things that that Retro does from the advanced squad leader, in that they kind of compress into the close combat phase what we would normally call the advance phase. And so any unit can move 1 hex whether it fired or moved or not. In the turn, the only 2 conditions are: number 1, it has to move into a hex with an enemy unit so to initiate close combat. The other condition is it cannot move into an open hex that is in range and line of sight of an active enemy unit. So looking at where our German troops are at the moment, these 2 guys are ineligible to move, and frankly it would just be a plain bad idea for them to move anyway. These 2 guys, different story. I alluded in the introductory video that part of my thinking was I wanted these guys to end up here, so I'm going to take them there with their advance. And obviously I want to put pressure on these objective buildings, so this stack with the 8-1 leader is going to move like that. There is no close combat, and we've done the movement part, so that concludes the German part of this turn, and we move on now to the Americans. And we just start that sequence of play again with the rally phase, and there is no rally phase, so it's time for movement. And not only do we have these 4 American units that need to get out of the street because they're now surrounded by Germans, we also have some Americans that are going to enter the board, and I need to figure out just where I'm going to have them come in. First thing I want to do is get my guys off the street. So I'm just going to move 2, 4, 2, 2, and 2, 4. And now as for these gentlemen, this is a stack of 3 747s and an 8-1 leader. I'm just going to bring them down this road. Line of sight is blocked in through here, so there's not going to be a hesitation to worry about. So I'm just going to bring them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I might add in here that in retro, there's no real immediate road bonus for infantry marching on a road. When I played this scenario in ASL, it was either this group or the group that comes in, I think, on turn 3, that I used a road bonus, and then I double-timed them, and I just brought them halfway across the board, it seemed like. It's been a while since I played that, but I took advantage of all those movement bonuses because of the way the Germans had ended up in their placement over the course of the battle. But that's not going to happen in this one, so I'm going to have to think that through and kind of clear the path while everyone's thinking. And speaking of thinking, maybe I wasn't thinking as the German player. Maybe I should have left this stack right there, because now I've set myself in for a world of hurt here. But having ended that, it is now the American fire phase. However, everyone that is on the board moved, so they're not eligible for fire. So now let's see what the Germans can come up with in terms of defensive fire. And we have this stack and this stack that are both eligible, and we'll go with these with this 7-0 leader. And he's got 2 4s, so that's 8 firing across the street. And we'll see what the outcome of that's going to be. And we have a 10. That's going to be nothing on the 8. And then we add an 11. I can't read. It's late at night. That's an 11. And we add 3. That's going to be a 14. That is off the retro charts. The retro chart only goes up to 12. And 12 is always a miss. So nothing there to report. And now I believe the Germans are going to have defensive fire. And they're going to attack the stack with the 8-1 leader, maybe in the hopes of shaking him up a bit. I should add here that we have 2 4s and a minus 1. That's an 8. But since they are at point-blank range, their firepower is doubled, so they'll be rolling on the 16 column. Okay, and that roll is a 5. That's not looking good. We're going to add a 3 because of a stone building. That's going to become 8. Minus 1 for the leader, so that's a 7 on the 16 table. And a result of a 7 on the 16 table is anyone with a morale of 8 or below is broken. So all of these guys have just broken under the sudden fire from the Germans. Now it's time for the American close combat phase, which gives them a chance to move. I'd like to add at this point, now that I have broken units, is those of you that are squad leader and ASL players may have noticed during the sequence of play that there is no route phase built into the sequence. That is because in retro, routing happens immediately. There's no waiting around, leaving them standing in the street. Once a unit breaks, they have to route out. And like in the in ASL and SL, the object is to get out of the open and into some cover. Well, these guys right here are already in cover, so they're not going to move. I've spent some time off camera thinking over what to do with these guys. I really want to put some pressure on here because I think these guys might be in trouble, although the rally phase may be good to them. We'll have to see. And I'd like to move them there. There's no line of sight. The problem is that the beginning of this next German turn, they're going to have somebody entering along this east edge. And if I was caught out in the street and they decided to bring somebody in, there could be trouble. I would thought about putting some smoke up, but under retro rules, you pop smoke in lieu of movement, and that would just slow things down. So I'm thinking if I stay there, that will maybe impede German movement here and force them to enter through here, get some activity going, and then I can move in. We'll just have to see if I have outthought and outsmarted myself. This brings us to the end of the close combat phase for the Americans, and that is the end of turn one. And at this point, I'm going to stick a fork in it because it's late at night, and I want to get this posted. So stay tuned for the next, hopefully, exciting turn. I think things are really going to start cooking at this point, and we'll just see where the battle goes from there. Thanks for joining me at the gaming table. Hope you've enjoyed the video, and we'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. And let's see what we come up with here. That doesn't look good. Okay, so that is an 8. I've got 8 on the brain tonight.